All right, good evening, friends. I'm gonna do a tutorial video for Earthsong. I think that with this song I can get through all four parts probably in one video, and I'll link in the comments to the timing for each section. So I will begin, of course, with guitar one. And yeah, I'll just try to be concise and get right through it. So guitar one begins after several measures of rest. So you're gonna count to two, since this piece is in 2-4, four times, and then eight more times. So a total of 12 measures of rest. And then you come in with these sets of triads. The triads, if you follow them, so it's G, B, and E to begin. But I would like you to play it actually here. So E with fourth finger on the second string, fifth fret, then B, third string, fourth fret, and then E, or G rather, on the fourth string, fifth fret. You're gonna get the same sound as this, but we're gonna use a nicer section of the guitar neck to get it. It's a much better tone there. Okay, so there's your first chord shape right here. And the second chord shape is really easy to get from here. I'm just going to, on the third fret, do a little two-string bar, and I'm gonna leave my second finger exactly as it is. So I started from this, and then bar on strings one and two. And that's the next chord. And the next one is also very easy. Keep the same exact shape. Move it up a whole step or two frets. Then you go back to the original shape. So if I count it, it'll sound like this. One, two, one, two. So on. Okay, so once again, that first chord shape is the trickiest one. That is second string, fifth fret with fourth finger, E, then B on the third string, fourth fret, then G on the fourth string, fifth fret. Okay, chord number one, chord number two, chord number three. Okay, then let's get into the melody at measure 29. This melody can be played in a couple of places. I'm gonna demonstrate it in the first position because that's the easiest spot to play it. So it does range up to the seventh fret B. That's the highest note of this melody. But it's really not all that hard to do. So here it is. Measure 29. One, two, one, two. So in measure 30, 1, 2, 3, 4, 34, I'm going to shift to the third position and play 1, 2, 1. So it's going to jump up to the seventh position. And then the last measure of this melody goes back down. So let me do that again, but correctly. So here it is, 29. 1, 2. Third position, reach up, then it repeats 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, third position, stretch up. Then at measure 37, you get largely the same deal. So here it is. Shift, stretch. Then immediately you're going to mute the strings and you're going to play just a rhythm of straight eighth notes with an accent on the first of every four. So we're going to count one and two and one, two and one, two and one, and two. Okay, and that goes on for eight measures, plus a repeat. Then we have the coda. The coda is pretty easy. We're going to start that in, I guess first position is fine. We're going to do a pull-off from G to E. So if you haven't done this technique before, you begin by playing the note, and then with your fretboard hand, you're going to pull down a little bit. And as you pull down, release the string, and it plays a new note. So from E to G, or rather from G to E, that's the pull-off sound that we're looking for. Okay, so we have a series of G-E pull-offs for a while. We're going to try to make the second beat of every measure nice and short because it's got that staccato marking. So here it is. One, two, one, two, one, two, one, two, one, two, one, two, and so on. Then at measure 61, you jump up here to the 10th position. And we're going to do a hammer-on, which is the opposite of a pull-off. So you play the note, and then you strike the next fret that you need. So in this case, from D up to E. And that's going to repeat twice, and then we have to get all the way up to G. At the end, we have G to E. So we start in 10th position. We're going to play 1. You shift, and actually that last one isn't marked as a pull-off, so maybe you just go, and it is going to be short. My guitar was doing some sympathetic vibration there, but try to make it nice and short. Okay, so that's guitar one. On to guitar two. Guitar two begins with that same pull-off figure that we just did. And that goes on for a little while, all the way to measure 20. So here it is, you wait 8 measures of rest, and then you come in with this. Oh, that should be a hammer-on. Let me redo that. So, we're actually in 3rd position for guitar 2. So we're going to do a pull-off here. And then we're going to hammer on D, which is 2nd string, 3rd fret. We're going to hammer on to E, 2nd string, 5th fret. So here it is, guitar 2, where you come in. 1 and 2 and. That goes on for a bit. Then at measure 20, you get a change up here. So at measure 20, we have a pickup into the melody, which is kind of like the middle section of this song. So here we have 20. You're going to play 1 and 2, and the next and is just going to be an open B string, and that's going to get you into your next melodic idea. So at measure 20, I'll play it in time. So it goes 1 and 2. Gets us to measure 29. So the trick to this section is to count the notes that are tied across the bar line. So at measure 22, we have a tie across the bar line. So the way to count that, you're going to count 1 and 2 and wait and 2 and. Or you can just, you can write in the counting, which is what I sometimes do if I've got a really complicated rhythm to do. So I might write 1 and 2, and then on the next measure I would just come in with the and, the next note that's not tied, and 2 and. So here it is counting in the way that I just described. 1 and 2 and 2 and 1 2 1 2, and here comes the next. is the next melody. So 29 starts on B. Pretty straightforward stuff. The only thing to watch out for in this section would be that there's an F sharp or two. In this piece, every time you see F, it's going to be played as F sharp. So here goes 29. 1, 2. 1, 2. Something that's about the same. If you scan ahead, it's, you know, the same melody. Then we have a four measure rest starting at 45, and then we get to this cool percussion section. So the chord that is given at the percussion section is technically not possible with the pitches that are indicated. We have all these little square notes, and it indicates low E, then G, then D, which, you know, it just can't be done in one chord with that particular voicing. So what I'm going to recommend is just hold an E minor chord shape, and we're going to do this tambour technique, which is where you just strike the bridge right at the strings. So we're going to count 1, 2, 1, and 2, and 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 1, 2, 1, and 2, and. So we might talk about, letting this particular sound, the tambour sound, we might talk about letting that ring. We're going to see how that sounds with the ensemble. But here's that section from that gets right before the coda. So I'll count it in time. 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, and 2, and 1, 2. 1, 2, 1, and 2, and 1, 2, 1, and 2, and 1, 2, 1, and 2, and. And then you get back into the senyo. Actually, at the senyo, you have some time to rest. So you'll come into a four measure rest after you do this 1 and 2 and 1, 2. So you'll count, you know, four sets of two there. All right. And that looks like all the new material for guitar two. On to guitar three. Guitar three also starts with rest, only four measures this time. And you're gonna begin with this stretch. So you have from the fourth string, fifth fret, all the way to the fourth string, second fret. And so we're gonna need to do pull-offs here, which are a little bit tricky. So again, you wanna pull down on the string, and you just use the pull-off finger to actually pluck the string. So at your entrance, you have 1 and 2 and. So then the only other technique there is that hammer-on from D open to E on the second fret. The trick with hammer-ons is not so much about speed and strength, but about placement. You want to get your finger to land right next to the fret wire, and if you do that, it really just doesn't take a lot of effort. But if you place your finger back here, you don't get a very clear sound. So make sure it's on the close side of the fret wire, and you should be able to get a good hammer-on sound there. Okay, so I'm going to skip ahead. You have a lot of repeated material. I'll move all the way to measure 29. 29, you have octave E's for a bit, and then you have C and E. So I recommend using first finger for the E that's on the bottom line of the staff, and I'm going to play this all with my thumb. So we have E, E, at octaves. And then we have C, E. Then we're back to E again. And then at the end we have A, E. Okay, so here's 29 through 36. 1, 2, 1, 2. So at 37, you're going to do a series of hammer-ons from an open string to the second fret. So it's going to start on the fourth string. It's going to go fourth string, fifth string, fourth string, third. So here it is. And that pattern repeats. It's a pretty fun place to play. Some people have a better luck using their second finger for hammer-ons, so I'm gonna show you that. For me, I actually prefer to use my second finger for hammer-ons like this. So here's what it sounds like starting at 37. 1 and 2 and 4th string, 5th string, 4th, 3rd, 4th, 5th, 4th, 3rd. Measure 41. Then you've got 4 measures of rest. Then at the coda, you pick up with almost the same thing with a little bit different ending. So the coda we have. So you're really just doing a hammer on fourth string, third string. And then you end with. And then you might want to get back to second position if you like, so you can get the last measure. Rather than playing the G open, I much prefer the sound of the G on the fourth string. It's got a much more warmer sound there. So from 59 to the end, you're just doing hammer-ons D to E. And so on. All right, then one more. Now guitar four. For guitar four, you need to be tuned down your sixth string to D. So as you do that, a good metric is like 2.5 turns on the sixth string will get you pretty close, and then you can just check it with the fourth string open. Okay, and then the other thing about playing with drop D tuning is any note that you would play along the sixth string is now going to be moved up 2 frets. The distance of one whole step. So we're going to start in second position for guitar four, and we have that same pull-off hammer-on figure. It's going to go G, which is now at the fifth fret, down to E, which is now the second fret, open D, back to E, like this. 1 and 2 and. For honestly quite a while. Then at measure 29 you finally get something different here. You can play this starting from G here, but it's a little bit easier to play G on the open third string, so I'll show you that. So at 29 we have a lot of open strings to play. There's no accidentals to worry about in this section, so here it goes. 29. 1 and 2 and 1. In terms of new material, That pretty much takes us to the end. Here's what the coda sounds like. This is measure 53. Can do that for a while, and then the last measure is just G to E. And you want a nice short E at the end. And that's it. All right, so that is all for the Earth Song by Jörg Kindl. Cool. So, like I said, I will link to the different timestamps for guitar 1, 2, 3, and 4. And if you have any other questions, just let me know.